हेलो एवरीबॉडी, आई एम डॉक्टर राकेश खंडेलवाल, वर्किंग एज अ स्पेशलिस्ट फिजिशियन विद गोल्डन सेंस मेडिकल सेंटर, एस्टर मेडिकल ग्रुप, बार दुबई, दुबई। हेयर टुडे आई एम गोइंग टू टॉक यू अबाउट फास्टिंग इन रमादान। एज यू ऑल नो, रमादान इज एन ऑस्पिशियस मंथ फॉर ऑल द मुस्लिम कम्युनिटीज। रमादान comes from the Quran, where the fasting leads us to a pious soul. For many people, the fasting gives a question that is it good for me, or are there some health related issues attached to it? So here we will talk about physiology of fasting in Ramadan. For most of the people, technically speaking, the fasting starts 8 hours after last food intake. That is when the absorption of the nutrients from the gut finishes. Usually, the body stores glucose in liver and muscles for consumption at a later stretch of time, and this glucose is the first to be utilized in the phase of fasting. After this consumption of glucose, the fat deposits take into account for providing energy for the rest of the period. After this fat burning goes on, in addition, the protein is also taken into account for providing amino acids and energy, and there really the starvation begins. But in the Ramadan, where the fasting occurs from dawn to dusk, this phenomena of digestion of proteins usually does not take place. Usually, when you replenish your energies by taking food at the dusk time, immediately your body starts replenishing its glucose and fat loads. The use of fat for providing energy prevents the breakdown of protein and thereby helps in losing weight and better control of diabetes and blood pressure. Along with keeping check on your body weight, it also induces a process of detoxification. By the way, the toxins stored in the fat are removed slowly over the period of fasting by losing fat contents. Along with that, over a period of fasting for a few days in the body, certain hormones like endorphins are generated, which later leads to a feeling of well-being and a sense of elation. Balanced fluid and food intake is essential during the period of Ramadan. These balanced meals should also take care of your adequate amount of energies from carbohydrates, fats, as well as minerals and salts and fluids. The iftar and suhoor meals should essentially contain complex carbohydrates and fiber-rich foods. The complex carbohydrates are foods which slowly release energy over a period of time and will include like rice, oat, barley, semolina, lentils and pulses. Fiber-rich foods are those which are like green leafy vegetables, whole peel fruits and prunes, figs, etc. We should also avoid high carbohydrate rich diets and highly fried foods because they release the energy at once and lead to deposition of fat. We should also try to avoid coffee or caffeine because caffeine is a strong diuretic which will promote the water output. Iftar is the meal with which we break the fast. The iftar should begin with, as per the Prophet's guidelines, with dates, which will provide a sudden burst of energy for us. The fresh fruit juices will also be providing a similar kind of energy to us. Then the meal will follow, but the meal should remain a meal and it should not be a feast. We should try to avoid high calorie, rich and fried foods.